Hello everyone, back for some more Xenosaga episode 1. Now, we are just about finished. Oh, we are not actually finished. Right, this is the second out of three videos. Yeah, screw that one, in a big way. So, we have more people to find. More noses to smash. More experience points to gain, and more tougher items to equip. People remaining out of the 13. That cursed status, that is one idol protects against. I don't know what that does. That is very rarely seen. I don't think we will see it until. Maybe in the Soul and the Flame dungeon. If not, then might see it cast by one or two enemies in random encounters. In the final dungeon. I mean, that is I think that's it. That's the level 3 skill that you can extract from that accessory. Why would you spend that much skill points on that? Seriously? Not really in the mood for fighting that jellyfish again. Bugbears though, I don't mind those. They're fine. Alright. You are video game characters, you didn't break any bones. Just walk on out of here, boy. Or old timer. 8 people left. And this enemy, by the way, do not fight him without Chaos. I think. Chaos or Junior? Well, anyway, I brought Junior. But what he walkthrough says that this fight is dangerous. I don't know if I actually added that myself. But anyway, those things really are dangerous. Be very concerned when you run into that fight. Be very sure that your HP and EP are maxed out. Or things might take a somewhat crappy turn for you. It almost did for me. What clock shield is going to be good to have the skill in with? in the Song of Niflheim dungeon. Now I'm going to try to go back to the Dark Colony before we go to Song of Niflheim. We haven't quite wrapped up the multi side quest, and I think we can get that wrapped at this time. I mean, the next time we visit the Dark Colony Clinic, that quest can be finished. That cat being menaced by that lava doll on her face. We actually need to. Well, that cat counts towards the number of people we need to save. Well, cats are people too, I guess. Trick though is actually getting there. We have one or two more to rescue from the bakery, probably one from the laundromat. That's Mystic Nocturne. Spirit damage for every target. That is pretty much as useful as Angel Blow. I don't really have a damage comparison. I'm not sure if they are as good as each other. Or if someone has the edge over the other, but giving that, well, putting that on Junior for in one tech attack slot while having more typical piercing tech attack in the other gives him extreme flexibility. Can now fight both people and Gnosis. Not quite sure whether the Spirit's attack does much damage to mechs, but he can go up against those two now and not suck terribly. As I have to turn his back, so I don't get the sort of disadvantages that way. Not that that was necessary at all. These fights are still quite easy, compared to what we will be seeing in Song of Nephilim. Oh. Oh, his phone just started ringing. I hope you might hear it on the recording. That's all the switches. Shop as well. Oh yeah, you're so tough. Ooh, money. Through the long night. Oh well, anyway. So if we speak to Johnny before finding Mia, he will leave. Oh, hey there. And this is just the same as before. How do we get upstairs, though? That's the next problem. Which I do believe we can solve by just going up the stairs and through the door up top. Bada boom. Fixed it. Yeah. You keep talking, then you can go running away. At this time, at this recording was actually going on, I think 40 minutes. So I kind of want to rush things at this point, so I can fit everything into a 30-minute video. As you can see, the fights that I edit out take a lot of time. Hey there. Yeah, I'm just an NPC, says the NPC. I don't know if that was intentional, but, well, good on you, Monolith. In other news, we have one more person with a quotation mark, to save, on the way there. I'm actually contemplating ditching my Xenoblade Chronicles to save, just so I can get a different save file and hopefully get a different random number seeding or probability seeding, so I can hopefully get cold holes in the this freaking annoying gacha draw. That's at least two playthroughs on one save file, on that save file. I have done most of the quests for all but two of the blades in that game, Cosmos and one of the others. Maybe Torna blades, I think. And just what the fuck is wrong with me? Those 300 hours that I just want to throw out because I just want my Cosmos. She's not even my favorite character in this game. God damn, man. It sucks being a nerd sometimes. Anyway, through there is the final character, or final person that we need to save. So, right. Boom. Grab the kitty. Run. And we are ready for the boss fight. Okay. So, I'll just go back to Sector 26 and save the game stuff, and join me for the grand boss fight, and let's just say there will be cutscenes. Many a cutscene. Until then, I know I'm gonna love it.